So this morning I'm heading up to Rexburg, Idaho to train a brokerage up there called Team Green Realestate. These guys have grown from infancy to being monsters in their local market, literally just within a matter of a couple of years. Now they're known as the premier real estate brokerage in all of that part of Idaho. It's fantastic. I'm excited to meet with them. I'm excited to share with them scripts and dialogue and prospecting techniques and hopefully seeing a little bit of growth in their company. I'm excited to go on their podcast. They also have a podcast called Real Estate Hustle. I'm going on that today at 3 o'clock, and that'll be fun. This is by no means a paid endorsement for Beans and Brew. They nailed the breakfast bagel. It's an everything bagel bun with an egg, Canadian bacon, and pepper jack cheese, and it is perfect for breakfast. Isn't it strange that the man standing in front of me doesn't have a clue why he's waiting or what he's waiting for? Maybe it's me, but I'm not thinking about it. If I look in my heart, I could find a back door. Find yourself. East as I've been in Idaho. Never been to Rexburg. I hear it's really cold in the winter time. It's really cold right now. It's really pretty. A lot of farmland, a lot of trucks, a lot of tractors. It's really kind of cool place. I guess it's gateway to Yellowstone over here. So Rexburg is a college town. It used to be called Rick's College. Now it's Brigham Young University, Idaho. A lot of students cruising around. You have my sympathy,
but take you aboard. Hey, real estate hustlers. Welcome to episode 7 of the Real Estate Hustle, a podcast about everything to improve and grow your real estate career. And we are joined by Mr. Alma Merrill, all the way from Salt Lake City area.
So yes, we are excited to have Alma here today on the podcast. Alma is he works with a great company, the Everest Group, is Century 21 in Salt Lake City. Is the highest ranked, highest producing Century 21 company in the world.
Ooh.
I mean, huge.
And, awesome.
And so he's so cool. Here with us. Alma's going to talk to us a lot today about some really great tactics, role play, some content about dealing with for sale by owners, cold calling, objection handling. We just had a great meeting with Alma, and he shared some of these things with us. So we're going to start things off with asking Alma 3 questions.
Excellent.
Here we go. So the first 3 questions that we're going to ask Alma is, number 1, if you could go back and start your career over again, what would you do different?
I would definitely be more consistent with calling. Prospecting.
Okay. Yep. All right.
All of the biggest producers in real estate mm-hmm. are prospectors. They have a prospecting base.
They're machines, yeah.
And then they compensate what they're not getting in prospecting mm-hmm. with SOI and with referrals right. and things like that. Mm-hmm. And so if you have a prospecting based business that you're consistent with, you're going to grow exponentially regardless yeah. of how many you have in your for sale or in your SOI or your COI.
Perfect. Number 2. What do you enjoy about your career?
Absolutely nothing. No,
okay,
I'm kidding.
Perfect.
I only like money. No. Yeah. So, you know, it's an interesting thing. So I came, before I got into real estate, I came from the medical industry, and I was a service tech, right?
Okay.
That was back when me and Rick lived in Southern California.
Nice.
Actually, when I first met you, this is, I think, what I was doing.
And one of the things I realized when I got into, or when I got out of that business, was I missed serving people. And so when I came across real estate, it was really a natural fix for that need. You know, it was really a natural fix to be able to serve people, help them in ways that literally make them cry sometimes. Boy. Change their lives.
Boy, so have we cried with some people.
We have. Yeah. We have. We appreciate that.
And I like that you brought that up, because it really is. We're more than just real estate agents. As we actually are in the business of changing lives.
It's exactly. Absolutely. So you know, I don't have any distinct desire or love for the structure of a house, right? Mm-hmm. It's what goes into the house and who's in the house and what we're accomplishing for people that really brings any type of fulfillment.
Thank you. Question number three. If you had one choice to jump careers and do something else, what would it be?
It would be kind of what I'm doubling as right now. That's a real estate coach.
Okay.
Yeah, I love real estate coaching. That's the whole idea, right? Was I want to help people. I just want to help more people now.
Right.
And
great.
So I started myrealestatecoaching.com. That's where I'm able to get down to the nitty gritty of what people need as far as scripts and dialogue, and use scripts and dialogue that actually work for people.
Right.
Not the stuff that's been around.
There's a lot of stuff online that's just so incredibly outdated. And
that's one of the most important things, is that it's outdated, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I look back at the way people spoke even just 30 years ago, even just 20 years ago.
Interesting.
Did we dialogue differently in the 1980s than we do now?
Oh, absolutely.
I'm guessing, yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. What I do with my system is just dialogue on a level that people understand for our day and age.
So the dialogue that Alma's talking about, it isn't a way to be more sneaky, under the rug, this or that, try to steal the deal or whatever. When we hear the word dialogue, what we're talking about is a way to understand.
We just had a really awesome office training with Alma. He just spent about a good hour and a half with all of our agents in our office and went through what he's going to be teaching you guys today on the
fantastic
podcast.
Fantastic agents, by the way.
And thank you. They are awesome people.
Agents.
You know,
that's right.
Just fantastic agents. So we are very excited that Alma made the trip up here. So Alma today was talking a lot about some objection handling. So a lot of times when we make these cold calls to for sale by owners, the walls are up. Why? Because 6,000 other agents have already called them.
Right.
So Alma, how is it? And you are so skilled at this and so good, but can you kind of take us through the process of bringing those barriers down on a for sale by owner specifically, who's been plastered with agent calls, get them on your level and set that appointment?
Definitely. And when you're role playing in your office, right? We did some role playing today.
Right. Yep.
My favorite role playing is not with another real estate agent. They're going to do and say things that real people don't do and say.
Sure.
Right?
Exactly. Like, she was so easy for me to combat, right?
Sorry, Drea.
Yeah, Drea, sorry. Yeah, you were easy. Even though you were like, oh, I'm going to be rough on you. Yeah. No, Drea, you were easy. So one of the things that I always recommend people do, when you're role-playing, role-play with real people.
Yeah.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Especially if you're in a metropolitan area like LA or Salt Lake City or Florida or something like that. If you're going to test out your scripts, your dialogue on real people, so that when you win, you actually get an appointment. If I go to Drea and I role play with Drea all day and I get really good closing her, that's going to be a lot different than closing a real person on the phone. Do we want to do a role play?
Let's do one. I think
let's
we should
do a role play. So.
Okay. Do you want us to pretend like we're not real estate agents?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah.
Pretend like we're really not. Try and back that.
We are. And at some point, right. You know, it may make sense for us to do. And I do these on my real estate, on my channel. I do live calls.
Yeah.
So if you want to see a live prospecting call, go to myrealestatecoaching.com on YouTube or Facebook.
We'll put a link in the comments as well, guys, and we'll link our channel to his channel today. These calls are awesome. They're phenomenal.
So you are a what? You tell me what you are.
I am. So I'm going to be just your middle of the row, $280,000 for sale by owner.
Okay, great.
Okay.
Ring, ring.
Hello.
Hello. Hey, I was calling about, you have a home for sale?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Okay. And you were selling that for sale by owner. Is that right?
Yes. Yeah, I am.
Okay, cool. Well, my name's Alma. I'm with Green Team Real Estate. I was just calling Team Green Real Estate. Let me say that right. I was just calling... I know you have, you're selling that for sale by owner, and purpose for my call is we just sold a couple of properties not far from you there. So I was just calling to get some info about your property. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's totally fine.
Okay, so I'm going to ask permission.
Right.
Okay.
Perfect.
It's critical. Yeah, breaks down their walls. It's different than, hey, I can do this for you.
Right.
Me. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you. So tell me a little bit about it. How many bedrooms does it have?
Yeah, we got 5 bedrooms in the house.
Okay. 5 bedrooms. Okay. And then 3, how many bathrooms? Is it 3?
Yeah. 3.
And then tell me about the kitchen. Any upgrades there?
The kitchen's oak, so it's, you know, it's a little bit dated.
Hey, I like oak.
Yeah.
I like oak.
Oh, good.
So you want to laugh with them and share in the obvious moments,
yeah.
Right? Okay, cool. So oak, and then, all right, anything else?
It's just a big flat yard.
Okay,
so,
cool.
Yeah.
That sounds good. Well, let me ask you this. I don't know if this would work for you or not. It may not, but I'm sure there's obviously a certain amount of cash you need to get out of this home,
right,
in order to make it worth it for you to sell,
yeah,
right?
Which is why we're doing for sale by
owner. And obviously, if we could figure out a way that by working together, we could get the property sold by listing it, putting it on the open market, and allowing more people to see it, and you could still net the amount of cash that you need even after the sell and paying commission, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, obviously, you'd be open to at least exploring that, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I suppose I would.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool. So what works best for you, afternoons or evenings?
I'm just super busy. I need to talk to my wife first.
Okay.
So
do you both work?
We do both work, yeah.
Okay. So what time are you guys typically home in the evenings?
It's usually pretty late, you know, around 8.
Oh, really? Okay. Yeah, that is late.
Yeah.
Well, fortunately, I usually work till about 9 or 10. Oh. Let me, how about this? Why don't you talk to your wife and just make certain that she's okay to meet? What I could do is come over at about 9 o'clock. I have a spot open on Thursday at about 9 o'clock. Would something like that work for you?
No, that's not going to work. That's just getting too late in the evening.
Too late, okay.
Yeah.
What about, like, would 8:30 or something like that work for you?
8:30 is a little bit tough. That's
well,
right.
And the reason I ask, okay, I am going to interrupt him right here. Because he just keeps running me into no.
Right.
It's because he feels a little bit of risk, right?
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to remove the risk right now. You know what? What was your name?
George.
George. You know what, George? When I come out, just so you know, I don't have any high-pressure sales pitch or any of that junk. Mm-hmm. We're just going to look at the house, make sure that it makes sense to sell, that you're going to be able to get the money that you need. If it makes sense for us to work together, great. Mm-hmm. If not, no big deal. Is that fair?
Yeah, I suppose that is fair.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So let's do that. I'll come over Thursday at 8:30. And then between now and then, George?
George.
That's ironic. My broker is George. So between now and then, George, what we'll do is I'm just going to look at the numbers, see if it makes sense for us to work together. If it does, great. We will list the property. And if not, no big deal. Is that fair?
Yeah, that's very fair. Yeah, I'm open to that.
Great. Sounds great. We'll see you there Thursday at 8:30.
Okay, great. Thanks, Alma.
We're taking the wall down brick by brick.
Right.
Your voice is calm.
Right.
You're not high pressure. You're just kind of taking the resistance, taking the no's, turning them around to ways you can help.
It's a very successful method for doing it.
Awesome. Well, I hope it helped you guys, and I hope everybody who's listening, it helps you. And, you know, my scripts and my dialogue are very specific, and that no matter what you say, no matter how your no is, I still have a response for your no. It makes sense and causes them to persuades them, right? You know the difference is between persuading somebody or tricking somebody?
What's that?
Your intention.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not tricking you into meeting with me.
Right.
I'm persuading you to do the right thing because my intention is to help you like I've helped 100 people last year.
Do you have any parting thoughts real quick in the last minute or so?
So the most important thing, number one, be consistent, create a cadence for your conversation, make sure you have a plan every single day and that you are consistent in your prospecting. You will be successful and strong in this industry no matter what market you are in, and be coached. Make sure you get a good one that works well for you, and make sure that you are being for them who they need you to be.
Perfect.
Love that.
Perfect. Well, thank you, Alma. We really appreciate you coming in.
My
great
pleasure.
Great thoughts, great ideas and advice, and I would encourage you to look up his YouTube channel. And
we have watched so many for sale by owner tactics, so many scripts, so many YouTube videos of people saying, this is how you do it, this is how you do it. Guys, this is the only one I've seen work. Everybody's really quick to share their scripts and their ideas. Alma's the only one that I've seen that puts live calls on Facebook and actually converts people into a sale. It's awesome. I think it's totally cool.
Yeah.
So, I mean, good for you, and kudos to you for being bold enough to show that, hey, my methods work. I'm going to show you right now with this real call.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I think it's rock on, man.
Well, I hope it helps.
So cool.
Good.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, thank you very much. Well, we got to wrap things up.
Hey guys, if you liked the content of this video, like, subscribe, and share, and we'll see you next time.